and welcome everyone. In this 8th class chemistry video lesson, today we are going to study about the representation of compounds and chemical equations. So starting with compounds, compounds are defined as the substances made up of two or more different kinds of atoms combined together in a fixed ratio by mass. The compounds are represented by using chemical formulae. For example, carbon dioxide is represented by the formula CO2. Ammonia is represented by the formula NH3. And calcium oxide is represented by using formula CaO. Chemical formula of a compound can be written by following some steps. Let's know about these steps with an example of calcium chloride. First step is to write down the symbol or formula of positive ion to the left and the symbol or formula of negative ion to the right. In calcium chloride, calcium ion is positive ion and chloride ion is negative ion. So symbol of calcium is written on the left and symbol of chloride ion is written on the right side. Then write down the valencies of the constituent parts below them. The valency of calcium ion is +2 and the valency of chloride ion is -1. So write down +2 below the symbol of calcium and -1 below the symbol of chloride ion. Afterwards, interchange the valencies and write them as subscripts next to the symbols. After interchanging the valencies of calcium and chloride ions, we get 1 as the subscript of Ca and 2 as the subscript of Cl. Here there is no need to write the plus or minus sign with the subscripts. Take out the common factor in the subscripts. Means if the valency can be simplified, then divide both the valencies with the common factor. Here the subscripts are 1 and 2 and there is no any common factor, so these will be written as it is. If any polyatomic ion is involved in the formation of chemical formula, then the formula of polyatomic ion is enclosed in brackets and the subscript is put outside the bracket. In case of calcium chloride, no any polyatomic ion is there. Then we have to omit the subscript 1. So the formula of calcium chloride is written as CaCl2. Let's now write down the formula of aluminium nitride. In case of aluminium nitride, aluminium ion is positive ion and nitride ion is negative ion. So aluminium's symbol is written on the left hand side and nitride ion's symbol is written on the right hand side. The valency of aluminium, that is +3, is written below its symbol and the valency of nitride ion, that is -3, is written below its symbol. After interchanging and writing them as subscripts next to the symbol, the formula becomes Al3N3. The subscripts 3 and 3 have common factor 3. So we have to divide the subscripts by number 3. And after dividing the subscripts by number 3, we get the formula Al1N1. As we have to omit the subscript 1, so the formula of aluminium nitride is AlN. Let us take one more example of ammonium sulfate. Here, ammonium ion is the positive ion and sulfate ion is the negative ion. So the formula of ammonium ion, that is NH4, is written on left hand side and the formula of sulfate ion, that is SO4, is written on right hand side. Valency of ammonium ion, that is +1, is written below its formula and the valency of sulfate ion, that is -2, is written below the formula of sulfate ion. After interchanging the valencies, 2 will become the subscript of NH4 and 1 will become the subscript of SO4. And as both ammonium ion and sulfate ion are polyatomic ions, therefore we have to write their formulae in brackets. Then there is no any common factor in numbers 2 and 1, so no need to divide these numbers with any other number. As we have to omit the subscript 1, so the subscript of SO4, that is 1, is omitted. And here is the formula of ammonium sulfate. Then our next topic is chemical reaction. A chemical reaction is a process in which one or more substances undergo a change to produce one or more new substances having different properties. For example, when iron filings and sulfur are heated together, they combine to form a new substance called iron sulfide. The substances that take part in a chemical reaction are known as reactants. Here, iron filings and sulfur take part in a chemical reaction, so they are called reactants. The new substances that are formed in a chemical reaction are known as products. Here, iron sulfide is a product. When magnesium burns in the presence of oxygen, then magnesium oxide is formed. It also represents a chemical reaction. We can also write this reaction as shown here. Here, the reactants and products are separated by an arrow pointing towards products. When any reaction is written by using this method, it is called word equation. Means, when a chemical reaction is represented by using the names of the chemicals involved, then it is called a word equation. If we represent the word equation by writing the symbols and formulae of the reactants and products, then it is called as a chemical equation. Therefore, the representation of a chemical reaction using symbols and formulae is called a chemical equation. Therefore, if we have a chemical reaction as hydrogen and chlorine combines in the presence of sunlight to form hydrogen chloride, then its word equation will be written as shown here. By using the formulae of the reactants and products involved in this chemical reaction, we can write the chemical equation as shown here. The conditions necessary for carrying out the reaction are usually written on the top or below arrow. In this reaction, the necessary condition is the presence of sunlight, so it is written on the top of arrow. While writing a chemical equation, the symbols and formulae of the reactants are written on the left-hand side and these are separated by plus sign, which means reacts with. The symbols and formulae of the products are written on the right side and these are separated by plus sign, which means also or along with. The two sides of the equation, that is reactants and products, are separated by an arrow pointing towards products, which means to produce or to give. So the meaning of the chemical equation given here is magnesium reacts with sulfuric acid to produce magnesium sulfate and hydrogen.